basically, for the Blackout recordings, we used the same stuff we were using for Lovedrive and Animal Magnetism.
Only one guitar, the Flying Rear. You know, you can't play so fast without the Flying Rear. That was, I have not done the slow V yet. The fast V. No, it's really, it was a perfect guitar for this edgy, powerful karate sounds.
We didn't really experiment too much. I probably added one or two extra guitars because it was like amazing to tour the US for 6 months and almost like every day off at least. If there was a music store in town, and they have great music stores, especially back then, you know, you could really find some really nice vintage guitars. And so I bought a few. I remember I had a 58 Strat with a maple neck, bought it at George Gruen's in Nashville. Still know him today. He's like the vintage guitar guru. And I have one guitar, which is also on the cover of Worldwide Live. It's an old Strat, which I had already before I did the audition. Like I had it maybe since 1977. And I was stupid enough to try to carve out a bigger hole so I could put in a humbucker pickup. I still have the three stitches here. You can see like a tiny little scar. And that was shortly before I did the audition. So I forgot to tell you this, but I came with a Band-Aid for the audition. And so I used a Stanley knife, which you use for carpets, you know, so I didn't really have the tools. It was quite risky. But this guitar I still have, and it's the guitar also because we, you know, we used to use a lot of tremolo arm techniques back then. I was one of the first, if not the first, official person who had built in a Floyd Rose system by Floyd Rose himself. I remember sitting on the Animal Magnetism tour in 1980 at the Rainbow Club in Los Angeles. And people talked to me, and somebody said, you know what, we talked about the inner problem that it goes out of tune when you use that tremolo arm. And he said, you know what, up in Seattle, there's a guy who made a great invention. And we, you know, it's always the same type of routing. We are on the West Coast, and we go up LA, San Francisco, Sacramento, up to Seattle, Portland. And so in Seattle, I met this guy. He came to the show, and he showed me his test guitar. And then I went, this is convincing. But then we were crossing the border, going up to Vancouver and staying at Calgary, Edmonton. And I think after Winnipeg, we came back down to the States. And so I only had two guitars on the road. I had to leave that guitar with him. It's like it was my, you know, my best guitar. And so, but I did. I thought, no, this is the right thing to do. So, and he couldn't send it to me because of customs and being in Canada. And then a week later, when we came back to St. Paul, Minneapolis, I found the guitar at the hotel with the courier service, and it worked perfectly. It was the old system, the first one he invented without the fine tuning, and it was difficult to be restrung and tuned, but I always did it myself until like the last couple of minutes before the show, and it made all the difference, because now all of a sudden you could use that thing without being so hesitant and careful. And it really inspired a lot of guitar players. I mean, look at Eddie Van Halen. Everybody used the Floyd Rose system since then.